15 things you didn't know about Grant Cardone. Welcome to Alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. Hello, Aluxers, and welcome to another exciting original video presented by Alux.com. Today, we're revealing some interesting and surprising facts about Grant Cardone, an incredibly successful entrepreneur, real estate investor, best-selling author, consultant, sales trainer, and motivational speaker. Grant was born March 21, 1958, in Lake Charles, Louisiana. He received an accounting degree from McNeese State University in 1981. After college, sales became his obsession and he became a very successful car salesman. He also started investing heavily in real estate. He began compiling his sales strategies into books like Sell to Survive and The Closer's Survival Guide, which helped him to become an in-demand consultant and sales coach. He is possibly best known for his book, The 10 Times Rule, which was published in 2011. He now owns four companies that bring in almost $100 million in annual sales, not to mention the hundreds of millions he owns in real estate. He is considered by many to be one of the top sales training and social media experts in the world. If you're new here, welcome. Be sure to subscribe and follow us on Instagram at Alux. Grant's bold attitude, extreme passion, incredible financial success, and confidence are a source of inspiration. So let's find out more about the man behind the success story with the 15 things you didn't know about Grant Cardone. Number 1. He quit drugs and alcohol after being thrown out by his mother. Grant says it was difficult going through his teenage years without the direction of a father, since his died when he was only 10 years old. In his late teens, he turned to drugs and alcohol, which made it difficult for him to complete college and hold a job. When he was 25, he went to visit his mother, but she threw him out of the house and told him not to come back until he was sober. He says this was the wake-up call for him, and he ended up quitting drugs and drinking cold turkey. He threw himself into his sales job to distract him, and for the first time, he felt what it was like to be successful. Number 2. It took over a year to convince his future wife to go out on a date with him. Grant is married to Spanish actress Elena Lyons, but it took him 13 months to convince her to even go out on a date with him. Grant says it was love at first sight for him, but Elena refused to go out with him or even return his phone calls for months. Grant approached the goal of marrying her with his sales mentality, and he calls Elena the toughest sale he's ever made. He called her monthly for an entire year and left her messages, but she didn't return his calls. A mutual friend told him that Elena thought he was too short and not her type. Also, she didn't date businessmen. Grant refused to give up. He finally got her to call him back when he found out that her main passion was clay shooting. He rented out a shooting range, hired the best coach in LA, and left her a message inviting her to join him for a day of shooting. She called him back 60 seconds later. They went on their first date at the shooting range and were married less than a year later. Number 3. He is a member of the Church of Scientology. Grant is a high-ranking Scientologist, and he reportedly is one of their highest donors. In 2013, he and his wife were given a Platinum Meritus Award for donating at least $2.5 million to the International Association of Scientologists. Number 4. He drives a Rolls-Royce Wraith. Grant has said that one of the stupidest things you can do when you first start making money is to buy a luxurious car. His advice is to wait until you're wealthy enough that you can afford to make dumb purchases and it won't matter. He considers his Rolls-Royce Wraith a ridiculous car that costs a ridiculous amount of money, but he says he's at a point in his life where it doesn't matter if he drops hundreds of thousands of dollars on things he wants. He decided to lease the car because, in his words, buying a car is dumb, but if he had decided to buy it, it would have cost him $384,000. Number 5. Tickets to his 2018 10 Times Growth Conference cost up to $15,000. Grant's annual 10 Times Growth Conference is a 3-day seminar that helps put entrepreneurs on the path to success with a focus on sales, marketing, and social media. If you're willing to part with $15,000 for the premier package, you can get a seat in the first 4 rows, get tickets to VIP events, attend a daily VIP lunch, have access to the VIP event area, and receive an event tote bag. If you would prefer to sit in the so-called cheap seats without any of the special treatment, tickets are available for $795. This is the second year of the conference, and it will be held in Las Vegas in March of 2018. Number 6. He is donating 100% of the proceeds of Be Obsessed or Be Average to charity. In 2017, Grant announced that 100% of the profits he received from his new book, Be Obsessed or Be Average, will be donated to the charities of Drug Free America and Drug Free World, which bring about awareness of the epidemic spread of prescription drugging of children, young adults, and seniors. The book goes on sale October 2017. Number 7. He has a twin brother. Grant has an identical twin brother named Gary, who is also very successful as the CEO of Chargebacks 911, a company that helps businesses identify areas of unnecessary revenue loss. Number 8. Cardone holds a $500 million real estate portfolio. Cardone's favorite thing to invest in is real estate, primarily rental properties. He currently rents out over 4,000 apartments and has a real estate portfolio that is valued at around $500 million. He invests through his company, Cardone Acquisitions, and he has never had to raise external capital. He started buying real estate as a side business to help preserve the wealth he made from his sales consulting company, but it has now become his primary source of income. Number 9. Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich is his number one recommended book. Cardone has written 7 sales and business books to date, but he also likes to read books written by other successful people. The number one book he recommends to people who are focused on financial success is Napoleon Hill's Think and Grow Rich. Number 10. He spent $20 million on a private jet he calls 10 Times Airlines. Cardone bought a $20 million Gulfstream 200 in 2015. He says he did not buy the jet for comfort, but so he could take time out of the equation. Instead of wasting time going through security, waiting for delayed flights, or waiting for a flight on someone else's schedule, his jet gives him control over his own time and money. Click in the upper right-hand corner if you want to check out our video of the 10 most expensive private jets in the world. Number 11. Consistency is very important to him. Grant considers consistency to be a key factor in his success. One way he likes to be consistent is in his morning routine. He wakes up, works out, eats a healthy breakfast, and then heads to work. As Grant says, the more consistency you can have in your life, the more productive you'll be. One of his pieces of advice is don't just wing it. Number 12. He considers many successful people to be his mentors. When asked about his mentors, Grant says that he's had many, but not in the traditional sense of the word. He says to him, mentoring doesn't mean he meets with someone in person over coffee. Instead, he is most often mentored by reading someone's book. He considers Warren Buffett, Mark Cuban, and Napoleon Hill to be his mentors, among many others. Number 13. After his first house purchase, he vowed never to invest in single-family real estate ever again. At the age of 29, Grant bought a single-family home in Houston, Texas. Initially, he was happy with his investment until the family he was renting to moved out. He thought it was a great hassle trying to find tenants and didn't like that it distracted him from his primary business. He decided to sell the house and he swore he would never purchase a single-family residential real estate property as an investment ever again. Number 14. Some of his former employees have filed complaints about being fired after refusing to go to Scientology training. In 2016, there were at least 3 complaints filed with the Federal Equal Employment Opportunity Commission on behalf of former employees of Cardone's Miami Beach business. Each filer made a discrimination claim after being fired, allegedly because they refused to attend the company's mandatory L. Ron Hubbard training. They felt Grant was forcing Scientology on them, and they were fired without proper cause when they declined to take part in the training. Although no further legal action has been taken yet, the company may face a lawsuit in the near future. Number 15. He lives in a $35 million condo in Miami. Grant lives with his wife and 2 daughters in a $35 million penthouse condo located on the 33rd floor of the Regalia condo property near Golden Beach in Miami. The condo features a 360-degree wraparound terrace with unobstructed views of the Atlantic Ocean and the Miami skyline. Residents of Regalia enjoy 24-hour personalized service, a champagne bar, wine cellar, fitness center, yoga room, spa, playhouse, pool, cabanas, and a beach club. Now that you've learned more about Grant Cardone, we'd like to know, is he among the people you look to for advice on success? Let us know in the comments. Still here? Here's a bonus fact just to thank you for sticking around. Grant has been hired by a number of Fortune 500 companies to help them improve their sales process and social media approach. These companies include Google, GM, Aflac, Sprint, Toyota, and Ford. Thank you for spending some time with us, A-Luxers. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpicked these videos, which we recommend you watch next. Thank you for being an A-Luxer, and we'll see you back tomorrow.